Hi, could you tell us your name and what class you teach?
Hi, I'm John Belcher. I'm a professor of physics here, and I teach 802 Electromagnetism 1 in the physics department.
And what are the goals for this class?
This is a general institute requirement. Every student who graduates from MIT has to take two terms of physics. One is mechanics, one is electromagnetism. 802 is the electromagnetism part.
Okay. And what do students actually do in this class?
This is a really innovative classroom. We have a lot of collaborative work in this classroom, separated by many lectures, and we do a lot of desktop experiments. This is the Dorbeloff Studio Physics classroom, which was built with a grant from Alex Dorbeloff. And we do a lot of things which are not traditional at MIT, but we find that the learning gains are substantially higher than normal lecture recitation format.
Okay, and what are the topics that are covered in this class?
Oh, we cover everything in electromagnetism, Maxwell's equations, through light, and we do a little optics.
Okay. So what pedagogical methods do you use to teach the class?
We have a variety of modes of teaching. We use a lot of mini lectures, but no longer than 10 or 15 minutes, where someone is standing at the console in back of me and lecturing to the students. This is a flat classroom, so we have 8 screens around the room where material is projected onto the screens. Then we'll intersperse that with desktop experiments where people will do actual hands-on experiments, I mean actual hardware that they do measurements with. And then we have a number of simulations and visualizations that help make those things more reasonable in terms of understanding by making the unseen seen.
Okay. Can you say more about the laboratory experiments that the students do?
We do about one a week over the course of 13, 14 weeks in a term. Each experiment is some aspect of electromagnetism. For example, we'll have them measure magnetic fields with a Hall probe. Some of the experiments have an A to D interface with computers. Students work in groups of 3 on the experiments, 3 students with 1 experiment. Sometimes the data from that experiment is fed into the computer for graphing purposes and analysis purposes. Sometimes it's not. But they all illuminate some aspect of electromagnetism in terms of experimentally seeing the phenomena, the real phenomena.
Okay, so how are the students assessed then?
The students are assessed by showing up to class and participating. That is about 20% of the grade. That means doing labs, doing in-class exercises, doing in-class problems, which we try to make in a collaborative sense so that students are working together. And also we have what I would call the traditional test, a large lecture hall in an evening. We put 300 students in there and have them take a traditional test.
Okay. And what kind of feedback have you received both from students and from others about this course? Because it has changed over the years, am I right?
Right. We have been taught this about 6 different times in this format. The first 2 were prototype with about 180 students. The first large course with about 500 students. And we don't put 500 students in this room. We have 6 sections. This room holds about 100. So the way we do 500 students is have the 6 sections of 100 each. We did that for the first time in spring of 2003. The learning great gains were tremendous, the best we'd gotten, but the student reaction was pretty negative. We made a lot of changes. We have focus groups and a number of different assessment measures, and as a response, in response to the student opinion. We changed that in the spring of 2004. We just finished teaching that, and the student reaction was pretty positive. Anytime you do something that's so radically different, I think the first time you go to 500 students, you're going to stumble a little bit. But we seem to have overcome those difficulties.
Okay, is there anything else that an OCW viewer might miss from just looking at the printed course materials that you'd like to describe about this class?
Well, of course, from the printed course materials, you do not get a sense of the collaborative aspect, and I think that's one of the most important things. When we put people into groups, we put a low, medium, high in terms of background. We hope the students teach each other as well as learn from us, and that's the one thing, of course, you don't get looking at this on the web. However, the simulations and visualizations we use in the class, which we're very proud of, which win prizes, are all available on the web, and those really help both our students, and we hope students outside of MIT to understand the concepts involved.
Great. Any final thoughts you'd like to share about the class or how it's changed over the years?
Well, I've taught this subject for 30 years. I've taught the large lecture format with 700 students in the early 90s. In my opinion, this is a much better way to teach. It engages the students in a way that a large lecture format doesn't. And I think this is the wave of the future in terms of interactivity. What I also think is the sort of visualizations we're doing to make the unseen seen, especially electromagnetic field lines, is also the wave of the future. It just makes things more comprehensible if you get a visual representation of what's going on.
Okay, well, thank you very much for making your materials available via MIT OpenCourseWare.
Sure, you're welcome.